Hare Krishna. Compassion needs to be felt as affection, not as condescension. Sometimes when spiritual teachers share their message, especially if they are super zealous, then they may adopt a holier-than-thou attitude where they look down at others whom they are trying to benefit. Their intentions may be good, but if their actions come out as arrogant or self-congratulatory, and when others feel looked down upon, then they just get put off. In today's world, people are not interested in spirituality in general. Most people are materialistic. And even those who become interested in spirituality, they have many obstacles coming from their own mind and senses and from the materialistic culture around them, which they need to deal with. While dealing with all these obstacles, if a speaker's supercilious attitude becomes an additional obstacle, then that is enough often to push them over the wall and they just go off never to return. So, we may act with compassion, but that compassion needs to be seen as compassion. And for that, people need to feel that we are affectionate to them. And that affection has to often be seen in their terms. Not necessarily by doing what they want us to do, but by being cultured, by being sensitive, by being gentlemanly. The Bhagavad Gita states in the 6th chapter, 32nd verse, Atma upam yena sarvatra samam pashyati arjuna sukham va yadi va dukham sayogi paramo mataha. It says Atma upam yena sarvatra. That by comparing with oneself, we learn that actually all living beings are equal. They're equal in their happiness and their distress, because they are essentially souls and they all need spiritual growth. They all need a connection with the supreme spiritual reality, Krishna. But while that is the ultimate cause of their distress, but circumstantially or presently, they are all feeling beings like us. And if their feelings are hurt, then their intelligence goes into the defensive. And they can't really hear. So by recognizing that we are meant to act in a way by which we see our commonality with them, not focus on their fallen condition and our elevated condition, but see that actually whatever be their circumstance, they are souls like us. And Krishna says earlier in 3.26 in the Gita that we need to speak sensitively. Na buddhi bhedam janayet agyanam karma sanginam joshayet sarva karmani vidwan yuktah samacharan. He says, na buddhi bhedam janayet. Do not let your mind get agitated. Do not speak in a way that agitates people's minds, because they need to be gradually introduced and elevated. So by recognizing that what is felt internally can't be seen by people directly, because they can't understand what is in our hearts. They can only see how it is expressed externally. And if compassion is expressed as condescension, then it will lead to alienation. But when compassion is seen as affection, then that evokes attraction and that inspires transformation. And thus, our mission of compassion will be fulfilled when people see compassion as affection and it inspires them towards transformation. Thank you. Hare Krishna.